60 grains. Here we go. Woo! It got her eating. Welcome back to 3R Ballistics, and today we have continued testing on the 30-06 sabot rounds. This test is going to be 62 grain projectiles only. We are going to be laddering up, starting somewhere hopefully around the 4,000 feet per second, and see if we can't get up to the 4,240, maybe even 4,300 feet per second. We're not going to full powder charge. I'm leaving something a little bit secret, maybe something in the next 2 months that's even going to help us even more with that. Ultimately, we want 4,500 feet per second in a 62 grain M855A1, but right now we're just using M855, just standard green tip, 62 grain, and let's see what we could do. Let's get out to the range. Okay, so we are starting with 58 grains of benchmark. This should only be going 3,800, 3,900 feet per second. I can't exactly remember. But we have two chronographs. Gonna make sure it's flying straight. Okay, Garmin did not read. Neither one of those read. Let's see if that thing was tumbling or going straight. And as we can see, it is flying completely straight and very close to my point of aim. Good sign starting out with the benchmark. Okay, so we had no pressure signs, but we also had no reading. So I'm gonna move the Garmin a little bit, see if we get something a little bit better. On either one of these, we are going up to 59 grains of benchmark. See where we are. We put 1 inch of stainless steel because it went through the polyethylene cutting board like nothing. Anyway, let's see if we can get a reading. The whole reason for here is being, see if we can get a reading. I am very close to that. Okay, you good? Okay, here we go. Woo! 3978. Finally got a reading on the Garmin. Knocked over that thing.
Stupid table.
Once again, stable and accurate. And if you look in the top left, we even catch the sabot coming in and out of frame. Everything looks good.
Still no pressure signs, not even close. So we're going up to 60 grains of benchmark in an M855. We did quite a number on that 1 inch steel plate. So we're gonna give it another shot and see what we could do. See if we can get a reading on here. Okay, you good? Oh, 4,025 feet per second. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Look at that. No pressure signs of cratering, no bolt lift, nothing.
So it's nice to see as we increase velocity past 4,000 feet per second, we maintain the accuracy and the stability with slightly better penetration.
We are going up to 60.5 with the M855. Here we go. Woo! 4,090 feet per second.
So once again, increased velocity, and we still have the stability and accuracy. But what I'd like to show in this video is the sabot. As it comes into frame in the top, and we slow it down, this is what we want to see. We want to see clean separation, and each one of those fingers is what we'll call them, that expands, are still intact. that's a good indication that we were using the correct powder. Not too fast of a burn, not too much to make the sabot disintegrate.
Okay, so this is the highest powder charge I have in benchmark, 61.5 grains. And I switched that plate from the stainless steel, 1-inch stainless steel, to 1.5 inches, 1¾ inches of lead. All right, so you ready? Here we go. 1¾ inches of lead. Woo, 41.19.
Now at this powder load with benchmark, I finally noticed that we had a little bit of inaccuracy as it shot a little bit higher than I was aiming, but the stability was still good. And as you see, here comes the sabot, good separation, and everything is still flying correctly.
M855, we are going H322, 60 grains. Should be going about 4,000 feet per second. Okay, here we go. Oh, that one hit 4,138. Woo!
Now, using a slightly faster burning powder in the H322, we had an increased velocity and more accuracy and stability than we did with the benchmark. So it looks like we're going in the right direction.
61 grains of H322. Theoretically, it should be going 4,200 feet per second. Okay. Try to hit more towards the bottom of that one. But that thing's peppered all over. Okay, here we go. 4,224.
And once again, we have increased velocity, yet we maintain the accuracy and stability. Looks like H322 is the powder we should use.
So back from the range, and let me know in the comments, what do you think? We mostly shot the stainless steel, the 304 stainless steel. It was a little over 0.8 inches thick, but at the highest powder load, we were able to get over 0.5 inch of penetration out of an M855. I think that's pretty good. And switching to the new powder was amazing. We got more burn efficiency, almost 100% burn rate, and we still have room for improvement. We have about 2 more grains that we can add, so I don't think we're gonna be able to hit the 4,500 feet per second, but we're gonna go for 4,400 feet per second. And we're gonna see the maximum efficiency that we can get out of this, a 30-06 sabot round. But tell me what you think in the comments. What else should we, you know, attempt to go through with our 30-06 sabot round traveling, you know, 4,400 feet per second in this next go round? And in about 2 months, we have something even more interesting in this 30-06 sabot round that's gonna do pretty good on lots of different hard targets. Can't give you too much but I'll leave it at that. And guys, subscribe, like, share, and until the next one.